Hello World of YouTube. Given this morning I decided to take a walk and sit with this band's 18th studio record and the 10th that they've released since I got into them, I figured I'd also be a little reflective and look at the record that got me into King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard. And it's crazy that even 5 years later, it's still an electrifying experience filled with killer riff work, a great use of its concept, and a cool-ass soundscape that they would also build upon with this creative, prolific career that they've had thus far. And so today, I'm going to be sitting down and talking about it. I'm talking about the 2016 classic, in my eyes, Nonagon Infinity. Now I get it. King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard now may seem like a hard sell. I mean, like I said, in the last 5 years, they've dropped 10 records. But Nonagon Infinity was something special. Even at their 8th record, which again, only in 6 years, that's still a lot of music. They've always been a prolific band. This was just sort of a gateway, it feels like, into what could be perceived as a mission statement by the band themselves. You know, Nonagon Infinity is truly an incredibly tight, concise, well-constructed rock record that showcases a lot of the band's talents while also having a really fun concept at its core, because it does have, you know, stuff songwriting-wise that the band pulls off incredibly well, like fantastical, vivid imagery, or just a good picture painted in its lyrics, like on the incredible 3-track run from Robot Stop through Gamma Knife that just has this groove that just sees you chugging along as the listener, that with the first time I heard it, it created this jarring experience when I realized I was 3 songs deep. And that imagery is also painted really well on the Throttling Closer Road Train, which picks the momentum back up and carries yourself back into the beginning of the record. That bleeds really well into the more societal reflective, we're talking about people in general reflective track, People Vultures, where even amidst its slower lurching groove that almost feels like it's alluding to where some of their career would go within the next couple of releases like Flying Microtonal Banana, it doesn't feel like the record loses any steam even with this desert crawling track, you know, or even on a track like Evil Death Roll where they spin this sort of aspect of nature, Evil Death Roll being something that crocodiles do with their prey, into this dark sounding lyrical track, or just having fun, you know, like on the track Mr. Beat, a track in a weird time signature that has some playful wordplay with its track name in the chorus about missing beats and stuff like that. That again has just a nice fun little groove that when I worked at a certain burger store, I was surprised to hear fall into their radio rotation. It does have a really good hook, and on this record they do have incredible hook work, like on some of the tracks that I've alluded, or Mr. Beat, or even on the album chorus that I'll get to in a little bit. Again, this record shows so much of what the band has going on from a songwriting perspective and from a musicianship perspective, because not only do those chugging riffs like on the first 3 tracks or the incredibly throttling closer Road Train show their propensity to craft good riffs. Again, tracks like People Vultures have this good texturing in the tuning of the instrument. You know, the organ stuff on Mr. Beat's a lot of fun. The groove on Wawa, which is another just goofy, fun song lyrically, fits really well in the pocket and its place in the record. This album is just such a fun run, whose concept keeps it fun. You know, the record itself has this concept, and everyone knows about it. If you've heard of this record, you know that it's the record that loops in on itself. Every single track bleeds together like one long jam session, or even the last track, Road Train, bleeds really well into Robot Stop. You know, and the fact that Robot Stop opens with the album chorus of Nonagon Affinity opens the door, Nonagon Affinity opens the door, wait for the answer to open the door, Nonagon Affinity opens the door, is fantastic. It's so great. And again, that chorus just creeps in throughout the record to just cement that this is all just one big experience that the band, I think, pulls off incredibly gracefully. And again, would be something that they kind of use throughout other pockets of their career, like Poliwanagondaland or the KGLW Twosome, I feel like, has moments where it's trying to emulate that smooth transition of songs between each other to create this sort of holistic experience as a record, which I admire. I really admire. As a fan of good album sequencing, I appreciate that the band pulled it off incredibly well in Nonagon Affinity, but also try to keep it going throughout aspects of their career, because I feel like it makes some of their records an incredibly smooth experience. And honestly, when looking at the concept, and given that this was a gateway into the band's catalog, the chorus of the record almost feels like the mission statement of the band. They themselves are just this ever-present, ever-lasting, super prolific band. Their output feels like just an infinite void of music just pouring out to listeners. And I feel like it feels even more ironic and hilarious in hindsight when after this record they became even more of a prominent face in rock music, because they had post this their 5-album run in 2017. You know, they did a couple of records here and there dipping into the same lyrical concepts across different genres. They did more microtonal stuff with the KGLW Twosome. They just dropped a synthetic record that was the whole sort of base of inspiration for me looking back at Nonagon Infinity. You know, King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard are certainly an incredibly talented batch of musicians who drop a lot of music. And I could see it being this daunting task, or even just an annoyance, as somebody who talks about music on the internet. But I implore you, if you haven't done so, or if you've sampled other aspects of their career and aren't as impressed, I would sincerely recommend Nonagon Infinity. Its soundscape embodies a lot of what the band has going on in Charm as well. It has this dry texturing that reminds me of like vintage 70s music in a very good way. You know, the drum tones on here are so punchy. The guitars have this crunch that I think works so very well for the band's musicianship in general. Their solos sound so cool in this production style, and I feel like Nonagon Infinity is such a great record that I know a lot of people have already talked about on the internet, because it's this interesting, again, focal point in their discography, because it comes after an already decent stretch of records, but comes before an even more daunting, insane stretch that they've been doing over the last 5 years. I think this band is incredible, though. I think that they craft a lot of good music. There's some records that they've done from then to now that I don't think are as great, but I certainly think they're one of the more consistent bands given how prolific they really are. It was nice to sit back and look at Nonagon Infinity once again. It's kind of insane to see just where all they've gone sonically between now and then. And that actually makes me curious to check out more of their earlier work, because for as much as I've enjoyed this run, I haven't gone any farther back in their catalog, because that's a lot of music. But nevertheless, Spin Nonagon Affinity, it to me is like a modern rock classic, and I think it's worth your time. I know I made a podcast sort of comparing Nonagon Infinity to Catch 33, but even in that podcast, I didn't really talk about it quite to the same capacity that I had today. And I wanted to use this as sort of a full-blown reflection on just this record itself, the impact it's had on King Gizzard's discography, I feel like, from this point forward, and how it almost acts as a great gateway into this band's particular brand of psychedelic-infused rock music. But what do you think of Nonagon Affinity? What's your favorite track on this record? What's your favorite moment? Let me know in those comments down below. Do you like the concept of a record that's ever looping? Let me know in the comments down below. And what's your favorite King Gizzard record if it isn't Nonagon Infinity? I also like Flying Microtonal Banana. I like their Brunswick East record. I really love Infest the Rasnets. I think that they are, again, a very consistent band for what they've got going on. But I'm going to get out of here. If you like this review, be sure to give it a like. If you want to see more of my music, gaming, and general nerdery content, be sure to subscribe. Special thanks to my patrons. If you want to join their ranks to get early access to content, exclusive content, or to help drive the community, it's linked in the description. This wasn't exactly the video that I was planning on making today, but I'm happy with it, and I hope you are as well. I've been Viral Rack. You guys have good days, lives, and situations, and I'll see you another day.